Meanwhile, the peak body responsible for Aboriginal out-of-home care, the Secretariat of National Aboriginal and Islander Childcare, or Snaicc, is at serious risk of closure due to a lack of federal funding, leaving around 14,000 children in dire straits. NITV video journalist Danny Teece-Johnson travelled to Melbourne recently and spoke with CEO Frank Hytten.
Snaicc's motto is kids safe in culture, not in care. And it's the most important organisation for Aboriginal families who have had children removed. But come June 30, it could be abolished, leaving Aboriginal families at the mercy of various state governments.
The third sort of aspect, of course, is that our funding is all a bit up in the air. We don't know whether we're going to be here in 6 months' time. And that's across the whole sector. Peak bodies generally have been cut, Aboriginal and non-Aboriginal, but particularly in the Aboriginal space, peak bodies are really important because that's a connection to membership and a connection through membership to community. You take away that and it's like cutting the head off something.
However, Snaicc workers say they just can't be worried about June 30. Instead, they need to plan ahead and continue to reduce the numbers of Aboriginal kids in out-of-home care.
The concerns that Snaicc has essentially remain around the number of children being removed and put into out-of-home care, and the lack of success, if you like, of out-of-home care in terms of dealing with those kids' emotional issues particularly. There's issues around loss of culture and community and family, obviously, and we want to address some of those issues. How do we do preventative work so that children aren't being removed in the first place? That seems to be the place to go.
But Snaicc says the federal cuts are both perplexing and polarising, as the mixed messages are crippling the sector. And ultimately, more Aboriginal kids will fall between the cracks into care and out of the community.
If they cut all the family violence service is gone, the legal service people have been cut, all those supports for ordinary Aboriginal people are being removed. So how a government can talk about being, or the Prime Minister can talk about being a Prime Minister of Aboriginal people at the same time as that government is cutting everything is really quite perplexing.
Danny Teece-Johnson in Melbourne for NITV News.